Today we're gonna show you how to play Simurgh, a worker placement game for 2 to 5 players from NSKN Games. This is actually a worker placement game with a fantasy theme, and in this game where each player has taken over the role of a clan, which is after a devastating war has taken. The opportunity to raise his dragons, which are shown with these exceptional markers, and the players are struggling over the city while they're trying to discover the wilderness, this side of the map, in order to gain the most victory points and to become the most powerful clans. So, what you can do in this game? Actually, the game is played over a series of rounds. We have several modes in which we can play the game. First of all, we can say that the easy mode is the one over here with the player board showing the spearmen, while the more difficult mode is the Dragon Lord mode, which we can see has fewer spaces for handling the resources instead of the biggest, the spearmen version with more spaces. So, each player in his phase can do two things only. Let's say that by the time we start, each player gets his player board with some resources, which are depicted here over the player board, which are two veggies depicted with these green tokens. One meat, the red token, one wood, one stone, two scrolls, and one spear, which are these. So, each player starts with this and also has taken his own color, a spearman and a dragon, and a dragon rider, which is actually, this is the logo of NSKN Games, like this, if you see it like this over here. It's very nice indeed. And in our phase, we can do two things. Either we can put a worker on the board map, or we can retrieve one or as many workers as we want from the main board. That means that in the beginning of the game, we start with these only two workers, the Spearman and the Dragon Lord. And if we actually want to place our tokens on the map, we can choose one action from the following actions that we can do over here on the board. We can see the symbols with the dragon, like this one, and we can see the empty symbols, like this one, the empty circles. That means that the spearmen, these people, can go only to these spaces, where the Dragon Lord can go to the spaces with the dragon symbol and to the spaces with the empty symbol. That means that the Dragon Lord acts like a wild card, okay? He can join whenever space you want. The only difference is that space which can only be joined by one worker. That means that only one spearman can join this one. The other places with multiple circles can be joined from all players as many times as they want. So, one action is this. When we get the action, and let's say that we put our worker over here, we resolve the action and we take the abbreviated symbols. That means that if I put my dragon over here, I can take a veggie or I can take one victory point, like this. So, I have to move the VP track 1 point ahead. For example, there are some other spaces like this, which has a minus symbol over here. That means that if I place my Dragon Lord over here, I have to pay 2 stone in order to gain 2 dragon abilities. Okay, dragon abilities are these, which we will explain as we proceed. Okay, so one movement is to place, but we can do that only once in our turn. We can't put both or more of our workers at the same time. And the other ability is to retrieve our workers. That means that by the time that we have, or when we think that we can do that, by the time we have the workers on the map, we can play our action and retrieve both of them and take it back to the supply of our supply. In our turn, apart from these two actions, we have also some free actions. One free action that we can do is that we can place a tile in the wilderness. The wilderness is this territory outside the city where we can put these cards. We have over here we have different categories of the wild cards that we can play. We have exploration cards, which are depicted from this boot over here. We have some production cards. We have exploration cards, some strength cards, which are all of them have unique spaces in order to perform some movements. So one of our free actions that we can do is we can play from our hand. Each player will start the game with 5 cards of these, randomly of course. We can play a wild card over here in order to make more choices available for the players and for us. For us also. In order to do that, we have to play also a vassal. That means a worker. That means a worker on the abbreviated space. That means that if all my workers are on the board, I cannot play this card without putting a worker on this card. Okay. That means that by the time I choose to play, let's say, this card, I have also to trigger one effect. That means that if I play, let's say, the dragon here, I have to pay another dragon in order to gain 6 meat. Okay. Or I can put it even over here. I have to pay 2 veggies in order to get 5 meat. Okay. So as we can understand, as the game goes by, all of these spaces will be filled with cards of different types. And by the time we also play a card, we take the reward which is depicted on the relevant square. Okay, so if I place this card, I'll have to take a veggie or a meat, or here I have to take a wood as a resource. Okay. Another free action is to play my dragon on exploration tile. As we can see, this tile, by the time we place this tile, we have to place also, as we said, a worker over here. So as a free action, I can upgrade my dragon and move a step further, which means that every time I do that, I take the following reward, which is on the, depicted on the left. Okay, so in this particular situation, I will take some VPs, which cannot, like 4 VPs, and I will take a dragon ability. Okay, so as I move down to this exploration card, my dragon gives me bigger benefits. Okay, this is a free action, but I can do it only once in a turn. That doesn't mean that I can do all these actions in one turn. Okay, as long as my dragon reaches the bottom, my worker is returned back, and this tile is going to the chronicle. That means in a stack of used cards at the side of the board. Okay. So another free action also is to play a dragon ability. What happens with the dragons? We will see now. At the beginning of the game, each player takes randomly a dragon, which is, we have plenty of dragons. That means lots of replayability. So every dragon has a different portrait like this. We have different dragons. We have the red dragon and the blue and the gold dragon. But what is important is that each dragon has different abilities. Okay, the abilities are depicted by 3 circles over here. That means that by the time we take the dragon, he's gonna be charged with 3 tokens, which represent 3 abilities. As a free action, I can remove a token and execute the ability that the dragon provides me. Okay. The same happens with the second ability and the third ability. So by the time I use all of the abilities, the dragon is considered to be exhausted. So in order to regain these abilities, I have to play an action from the board. There are some actions or some cards which can give me back the abilities. Yes. Like this one, for example, if I play my dragon over here, I can pay 2 stones and get 2 abilities. The rules are that by the time I get ability tokens, I have to choose where I can put them, but I have to always to fill from left to right. That means I have to fill the far left and then the middle. I cannot put it like this, okay? I have to fill the gaps in the order, okay? So the dragons are ready to be used again. I can use all the abilities in one turn if I want. There's no restriction that I can use only one ability in one turn, okay? It's a free action, yes. It's a free action. So this happens with the dragon, and that is the third free action that I can do.
Hand limit for the
dragon? Okay, there is no hand limit. There is no limit for the dragons that I can have in, on my side, on the table, okay? I can have as many as I want. And I can recruit them from this space, in which I have to pay one stone, one meat, one vegetable, one wood, and one spear in order to take three dragons from the pile. I will choose one of these, and the rest will be discarded either on the top or either on the bottom of the pile. Okay, there's no discarded out of the game. These are going either on the top or the bottom of the pile. Okay, and then I will keep one, which will be charged with three abilities, ready to be used. Okay, okay. Now, why I need these dragons, the Simurgs? Because the game is named after the dragons. I need the dragons because there is also a square over here, which I can place also a Dragon Lord to execute the action, in which I will take three objective tiles, and I will choose one to keep, or maybe none to keep. It depends on me. These tiles, like we see over here, have pictures of dragons, different types. The red dragon, or the blue and with the yellow lines over here. That means that if I have dragons collected from during the game, different portraits, I will gain the exact amount of points if I put this objective token on the square by having to pay the exact resources. So if I want to use this objective tile, I have to pay either between two vegetables and two meat. This will give me 2 points, okay, 2 victory points, and I will place this tile over here. That means that by the end of the game, as we score, the player who will have the most dragons with this portrait and the with most abilities on these dragons with these portraits, the most abilities unused, that means, will get 12 victory points. The second player will get 7 victory points, and the third player will get 4 victory points. The objective tiles are plenty, so this actually boosts player to collect dragons, to enhance their abilities, and even to complete objective tiles. Okay, so this is a good reason why I should take in mind to get a new dragon apart from the one that I'm starting the game. Also in the dragon board, I don't know where. Let's say we can find one, for example, to explain something. Okay. There is no. Okay, in some dragons there will be some abilities which have the sign
forbidden,
yes. But it seems that I can't find anyone over here. No? Okay. If we see the forbidden sign, that means that this ability will be executed only once for the entire game. That means that it cannot be recharged, okay?
It's a boosted ability.
It's a boosted ability, yes, and it can be used only once. So that token will not be be able to be recharged on the dragon. Okay, there are also some other rules. For example, we have also a special movement here where we can play a wood or a stone in order to pick a card from this available to boost our hand for a future use. These cards are taken from this deck and resolved and are put from number 4 to number 1. That means that the card on number 1 is the cheapest card, while the card on number 4 is the most expensive. So by the time we take a card, let's say I take number 2 card because I paid 2 scrolls, okay? I take in this card on my hand. Number 3 goes to number 2, number 4 goes to number 3, and a new card is played number 4. This is the most expensive because it will grant me 3 points, but I have to spend 2 scrolls and 1 spear. Where I get 2 points, 1 scroll to pay and 1 spear, where I have to pay only 1 scroll in order to get this. So as a game progresses, these tiles are getting cheaper and cheaper. So maybe I should wait in order to get the tile cheap, or I should pay too much money to be the first to get a tile. Okay. What else can we say?
When it ends.
Excuse me?
The game, when it
ends. Okay, the game ends in... it has different modes in order to tend to end the game. One mode is the short mode, in which by the time 8 tiles from this one, from this side of the wilderness, are moved out, the game is over. These tiles can be moved out either when our dragon is reached below, okay, or we can remove them by playing a spear in order to remove a tile. So if I play a spear, I can remove a tile and give, if that tile has let's say meeples on it, by playing a spear I can remove this tile and give the meeples back to the owner, okay, and put my own tile.
Or if the last worker is a thief, tile.
Yes, or if the tile is full of workers.
Ah.
Okay.
Or if someone retrieves the last worker from a tile and it becomes empty.
Yes, or if the tile becomes empty. Yes, because one of the actions that the players can do is to retrieve as many workers as they want. Okay, so if I have a worker over here and retrieve it, then this tile is exhausted.
Okay.
So if the chronicle, which is this pile over here that gathers these tiles, is collects 8 cards, the game is finished. You can do it. This is a small, the short version. The medium version has 11 tiles, and the large version has 14 tiles. Also, there is also another rule about finishing the game. If we have revealed 4 objective tiles over here, then the game is finished, apart from the chronicle. Okay. Then the player with the more VP wins the game, which are also the VP are tracked.
Around
the board, yeah, exactly. And we also get extra points from the dragons with the most abilities on them. And also we turn over the resources, 3 resources for 1 point. There is a clever also end game scoring for the dragon lord mode, like this over here from this side. Where the game awards you if you have an excellent resource management. That means that if you end the game with no resources, you get 5 victory points. If you get the game with some other resources, which I can't recall, you get fewer points. And if you have a full your game board with resources, at the end of the game, you get no points.
Okay.
So this is the game. It takes about 60 to 90 minutes with 5 players. And I think it's just a nice game to play as a worker placement game. Enjoy.